I think it's the most important thing I've ever done. As you probably are aware, I do a great many things because I'm insatiably curious. I've been in movies on the operatic stage. I'm a sculptor, I'm a writer, a best-selling author. There's a lot of things I've done. But the thing I think I've done the very best of all, and the thing I'm proudest of, is being a father. That's the hardest thing to do well, because it calls for selflessness, it calls for self-abnegation. I put away at least half my career for the sake of my children. I don't mind one bit, I'd do it again, because now they're all around me.
He has always loved us with his whole heart and been there for us and made Herculean efforts to get to things when we were kids, even if he was out of town working on something.
He is the quintessential father. He is, you know, endlessly giving, endlessly selfless, and probably I would say, you know, endlessly concerned. There's nothing he wouldn't do for his family.
He loves being a father. It's probably the thing he's most proud of. Even after all the successes in his life and his career, I would say he's probably as proud or prouder of that than anything. And it means so much to him.
He has always chosen in every moment of his life to do everything he could for us when some other people might have been more selfish. And I feel just blessed to have him in my life every day. And I love him. He's just a dear, wonderful man.
They always came first in my life, and they still do. Whenever I could, I took them with me to location, whatever shows it, because they were first to me. Life wasn't life without my children near me. They say there are 27 million diabetics and 6 million are unknown. I bet you it's more than that. People in rural areas, people who just die from it, who just don't know what it is, who don't get a chance to go to doctors and get that diagnosed. I had it for a year or two without knowing I had it. I was just thirsty all the time, get tired, and you know, I was lucky that it didn't do me in.
It was scary earlier on, but I think he's gotten quite a good handle on it. He knows how to eat better, how to watch his numbers, how to do enough but not too much. And he's been really, really fearless about going out and taking a good opportunity to do some good with something that actually was an affliction. But he's living a great life still, and he's actually helping other people to know about it.
Whenever I go to the house, there's nothing really fun to snack on now. There are no fun sodas in the refrigerator. There are no like really bad potato chips or ice creams or chocolate cakes. He kind of lives this life religiously, and everything is extremely diabetes health conscious.
Initially, he was nervous to let people know that he had diabetes because he thought in some way it might weaken his image. And then, you know, we both decided that, no, it was actually a stronger thing to say, hey, look, I've got this issue, but here's how I'm dealing with it. And if he could be that bold to express that to people, that maybe they would get healthier too with him as an exemplar.
You get to the point where you say, well, it's unfortunate that I have this, but I'm alive, and this is something that I can do, and this is something that may help some people. It may help raise some money and awareness so that somebody who has diabetes type 1 doesn't die right away. A little child who has to suffer 8 testings a day and has to get the injections, that just breaks my heart. Let's get a cure for this thing. Let's stop that from hurting children.
I've never seen a man do so much for his children and be so constantly involved in their lives. Anything that befalls us affects him, from a scraped knee to a personal disappointment to a more major loss. He feels it as deeply as we do.
He just has such compassion for everything and such an amazing respect for life. He's kind of, I think, made all of our family understand that we really need to do so much more in this world.
You don't know what gratuitous love is unless you have children, unless you've been in the emergency room at 4 o'clock in the morning, watching them treat your child for a terrible thing, a high fever or something like that. You don't understand what it is to be a truly loving individual.
He's taught me how to be professional and how to be fearless, you know, as an artist. You know, he taught me to stand up for myself, to be more direct.
Dad would always say, Amanda, don't worry. Everything's going to be all right. You know, whatever you're going through, you know, I can help you get through it. I'll always be there for you. And he always was.
He always said to me, you have to have the courage to give yourself the license to fail, and then you take a big giant swing at it. You go at it with everything you have in your heart, your instincts. You know, you make a big, bold choice, And then if you fail, so what? What's the worst that can happen? Unless you give yourself that freedom to really leap into the void, you'll never do something really special.
He also taught me how to be somebody, you know, who can be close to his father.
Everything he does full on. And that translates into his fatherhood.
He's always been about family. He always was very honoring of his own parents and all of the extended family when he took care of both of his parents until the end of their lives.
To have other people recognize you for what is the most important thing in your life, which is your children, therefore your fatherhood, this is a wonderful thing. No one's perfect. I was certainly not a perfect father, but I damn well tried every day of my life.